If you've ran ads on Facebook for lead generation, you know that leads can vary in quality wildly, and oftentimes you will get a ton of dog shit, lowball tire kicker type of leads, and then very few actual good leads sprinkled in, right? What can you do to fix that? What can you do to improve the lead quality? What can you do to pre-qualify them? Well, conditional conversion events are the winning magic sauce, the big secret to making that happen, right? So what they do is they pre-qualify leads, they improve lead quality, and they get better results. I'm not trying to turn this into a webinar here, but conditional conversion events, which I'm going to cover, are something that work incredibly, incredibly freaking well. I use them. I spend tens of thousands of dollars a day. Literally, I spend over $10,000 a day of my own money using conditional conversion events for lead generation. So let's kind of take a step back here and explain the traditional method of lead generation on Facebook ads or even Google, any lead generation platform that uses machine learning, right? There's typically a landing page and you capture some information. It doesn't really matter what that is, name, phone number, email address. And then there's a button. Then when the user clicks the button and then reaches the thank you page, it triggers a conversion event. So let me just kind of put that down here. Oops, why is my thing? I'm using Zoom to do this. There it is. Let me change the color. Not too good with this little tool, although I try to use it often. Thank you. Page. That leads to the conversion event. So the user comes through, fills out their information, you capture the lead, that triggers the conversion event, and that conversion event gets sent back to Facebook. If you have it set up right for conversion optimization, which you should before you're doing any type of ads, link clicks, traffic, impressions, reach, awareness, all that other stuff is bullshit. You need to be focusing on meaningful actions that you can derive from any type of machine learning advertising platform, which Facebook ads and Google ads are the two biggest ones out there. And then Bing, much smaller, but it does work as well, depending on which vertical you're in. Anyways, that's a whole nother topic I can talk about for hours. Conditional conversion events, okay? So traditional, you fill out some information, or the user fills out the information, they submit, they reach a thank you page, there's a conversion event, you got the lead, right? Well, that doesn't tell us anything about the lead other than that they have some interest, right? It doesn't discern how quality they are. If they're good quality, bad quality. Are they ready to buy now? Do they have the money? Can they afford to buy? That's where conditional conversion events come in. And this is what savvy marketers are running here. So let me explain this here, right? With this, with a conditional conversion event, we run a lead form, but then we ask a qualifying question. Okay, so in this case, it might be, what is your budget? It could be, how soon do you need service? Is this an emergency? Have you read our online reviews, etc.? Just come up with one qualifying question. You know, you could come up with many, but just start with one. It's going to radically improve your lead quality. And then you want to have the conditional conversion event triggering only when they match a specific conversion. So in my example right here, you might say, what is your budget, right? And then you have these options. Well, you know, for a home service like remodeling, $1,000 to $3,000 budget is peanuts. Can't do anything with that. $3,000 to $5,000 probably ain't going to work with that either. You only want the people that are already expecting to spend some money, at least $5,000. They've either gotten other quotes, they've talked to some friends, family, neighbors, they've researched things, and they understand what the project costs. Because if you're just running ads for remodeling, people might think, oh, you can remodel a kitchen for a grand. No, you can't even get a fucking permit for a grand at this point, okay? So you need to conditionalize it here. And then what you want to do is only have the people that select positively to your question. If that's, you know, what is your budget? You know, any option that's $5,000 or more, that triggers the conversion event. And that triggers a conversion event to get sent back to Facebook ads or whatever machine learning platform you're using, right? Now, people will still come through if they fill out, you know, these lower options or the negative responses to your qualifying question. They still come through and you still get those leads and you can handle them accordingly. But the big takeaway here is that only the positive leads or the people that answer the question positively are triggering the conversion event. So that's getting sent back to Facebook. And now Facebook is just looking at the market segment or the user segment that is selecting that higher ticket budget here. And then what's it going to do? It's going to go out and find people like those people that are likely to select this right here and qualify. So essentially you're saying, hey, Facebook, these are the qualified people, find me more people like these, and not letting all of kind of the lowballers, tire kickers, unqualified, negative pre-qualification, whatever you want to call them, I think you get what I'm talking about here, you're not letting those people get through and sending that data back to Facebook. So you're essentially filtering to the qualified applicants here, sending that back to Facebook or Google Ads, and then it's going out and finding more people that are going to select that answer. And then once you get this set up, the value of your lead generation just increases exponentially. Because as I said in the beginning, if you're running Facebook ads and you ask this question and it's not conditioned, like let's just say you're just, well, you don't even have anything there, right? Let's just remove that. And everybody can just come through. You know that probably, I don't know, let's just say kitchen remodeling, probably 75% of your people are going to select these two options right here. And that isn't really what you want to work with. You really want to work with the people that understand the costs, because those are the people that are really going to buy, at least buy easier, without having to go through a nurturing sequence and without having to, you know, go through the whole tire kicking process and come back in a year. You want the people that have a budget that's realistic so they can buy now. But if you're not doing any qualifying or conditional conversion event, you're going to get people that are probably 75% going to be in these lower budget options right here. And that's not what you want. That's not what you want to work with. You want to focus on these higher budget people. Yes, your cost per conversion will be higher, but you're working with a much higher quality lead. So let me know what your thoughts are, guys. Is this something that you are going to implement? Let me know in the comments below. Otherwise, guys, that's a wrap on this video. If you're looking for more marketing experiments and insight from me, look for the No Bullshit Marketing Facebook group. That's where I share all of these videos. I'll see you on the inside there. I'm signing off on this one.